Let me start by telling you what Michelle Obama said. Michelle Obama in her Netflix documentary Becoming, you can check it out. It's a fabulous documentary. You can thank me later for it. She said that you have to be strategic with your image, because it has the power to define you. So during Barack Obama's campaign, she was perceived by a lot of magazines and journals as a very angry woman. And as soon as she assumed the position of the first lady, she hired a fashion consultant and she said, "I do not want to become a victim of fashion. I actually want to use fashion as a tool to help me project my image in a way as to in whatever scenario I am in." So getting a personal consultant actually helped her in a lot of ways. Like if she was going for a humanitarian cause, she would wear like lighter colors and softer free-flowing fabrics to just show that she has a humane side to her. And when she actually wanted to assert power and look authoritative, there were sharper cuts, there were deeper tones. That would project that, yes, she assumes a position of authority. So in whatever way she dressed, then the conversations followed. Also, now that I've given you a little bit of background about how an image consultant helped a politician, I am also going to tell you what is the importance of an image in front of a lot of people. Normally, and it's a study that shows that 55% of whatever another person is going to remember of you, 55% is going to be just visual. What you're wearing, what is your body language, how do you project yourself in front of people. I know it's very tough to believe, but 55% being visual, 38% being vocal. How are you saying it? Your hi versus hi. That kind of a difference. So vocal is also extremely important, and only 7% is actually what you are saying. How sad is that? But I'm not saying that the content does not matter. What I'm saying is that there is a way that people are going to perceive you. If you're a lawyer and if you wear shorts and go to court, you think it's good? I mean, people are going to take you seriously? Or versus if you're a CEO and if you're there in a very casual way, or if you're an artist and you end up wearing a suit and going for your painting sessions. Creativity has its own kind of you project your different kind of an image. And when it is formal, when you have to, you speak volumes with how you're dressed and what you want to project to people. So now that that is also sorted as to why it is important, let me tell you the difference between an image consultant and a stylist before going to the real meat of what I want to say and how you can style yourself. First and foremost, I'm not going to talk about money and most expensive things. Expensive is not it is not about all things expensive. It is about your body. What does it want? It is about your age. How do you want to project yourself? It is about, what is it that you actually want to do? So it is about quality over quantity. Now I will tell you the difference about an image consultant and a stylist. For a stylist, which also branches out of image consultancy. So for a stylist, it's, one event. You are a mannequin. Whatever you want to wear, that stylist is going to style that outfit for you. You are not a person for that stylist. You are a mannequin. Whatever will look nice on you, that stylist is going to put it on you. So, whatever rings or bracelets or earrings or accessories, whatever is going to look good on you, that is what a stylist is going to do. What celebrities do, stylists take care of them. What image consultants do, we understand the person. We will first find out what is the client's lifestyle and preferences, and where does the client actually want to what is an image that the client wants to project to people. So say again, I'll go back to the example of a lawyer. If you're a lawyer but you have very cute girl round face and stuff like that, and you're like, oh, people never take me seriously, what can you do? You can actually play with clothes. You can give yourself cuts and fabrics and textures, and your body analysis can be done in such a way to give you a certain kind of clothing and certain kind of colors. Also colors have their own language. So if you give people things that they are missing, an image consultant can help you fill that gap. and project that image. So the girl with the round face and cute curly hair, she can also look like, you know, an authoritative lawyer, provided she has the right kind of clothes. Now, if a school girl, she is going to college and, you know, she's not confident about how she wants to project herself, welcome to the world of image consultants. And, you know, you can always get like a brief capsule wardrobe about, that little girl, she has, she has a thing for jackets and she's always been she's been wanting to wear it. So why not create like a capsule, a small little wardrobe of five color outfits or stuff like that. So, you know, you can teach her how to make color coordinated things you can take care of a teenage girl. I can do the same thing for a bride, or, you know, if she wants her trousseau in whatever colors she feels that they are going to look nice on her, whatever patterns, because you have like a wide array. You have to go to parties, you have to go for a honeymoon, whatever. So from different categories of people, you are just starting out, you have a startup company, you want to go to investors, you want to get some money, you want to raise money. How do you again do that? Your body is going to speak. 55% of whatever you are, your body is going to speak via your clothes or however you are presenting yourself. So just go for it, guys. You know, you're an artist. We can take care of it anyway. So repeating myself, stylist will take care of what you have to wear for just one single occasion or something like that. But an image consultant will give you a goal that, okay, you want to reach that goal. These are the things that, you know, I can help you with. And you can just take care of those things and probably just add them to your wardrobe and you are sorted. Moving on, the first and foremost thing that you need to do, you cannot escape it. You cannot say that this is, you know, I can just take care of that, because the first thing is wardrobe planning. So it is much easier. We all know it's much easier to get dressed if your wardrobe is organized and everything is visible. You actually get, you know, very calm, zen-like feeling if your wardrobe is in place. That's the only thing that you have to do is, okay, so this is what my mood is, tuck, 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 and you are sorted. And trust me, every woman deserves that calm, zen-like feeling. So again, every fashionista, she suffers from a FOMO, fear of missing out. What am I missing, you know? Every fashion thing has to be in my closet. So we are just hoarders, let's face it. Every woman at some point in time has had this problem that, you know, I have too many clothes but nothing to wear. So even during lockdown, despite the fact that you've cleared up everything, I'm sorry to say, but things have made way back into your cupboards, because ghar pe pehenne ke liye kuch nahi hai. So back to square one. So let us now understand that how can you plan your wardrobe. The best rule, and it's going to be a revelation, guys, the rule for wardrobe planning is 80-20. 80% of the times you wear only 20% of the contents of your wardrobe. Trust me, you can try it. 20% is only that actually gets used. The rest 80%, kisi ka kuch kharab hai, kisi ka kuch kharab hai, something or the other has to go wrong. So it is time to say bye-bye. Now, how do you say bye-bye? How do you actually sort those 80% and 20%? Make 3 boxes. As soon as you empty out all the contents of your wardrobe, it is imperative that you do, if you can, lockdown head, try it, you know, if it works for you. So empty out all the contents, make 3 boxes, keep, store, discard. These 3 boxes they are like the only mantra that can actually save you from, becoming very crazy about what your wardrobe looks like. Keep what is still brand new. You can just tweak around and, we can always work around whatever you have. But, and if at all you want to, you know, after the session, I'm sure that you yourself will feel very equipped that I can handle things and, you know, I can really do some styling on my own. So keep what is brand new. Keep your colors. By your colors, I mean, when we going forward, I'm just going to talk a little bit more about color analysis. And color analysis means that every person will fall under a color category. So keep your colors, whatever colors will look nice on you, which we will decode as we move forward. So keep your colors and keep things that fit you the best, because thanks to India and thanks to the fact that we can get a little bit of customized tailoring, you can always replicate those cuts and patterns by taking it to your local tailor. So please enjoy those, keep them, store them. Anyways, so now moving on to store your memories. Come on, if they don't fit you, how do you think they're going to fit your wardrobe? It's more like a no-brainer. And of course, keep the outfit, store the outfits that do not belong to this season, because no matter how much you like that say Ralph Lauren blazer, you are not going to wear it in this season. Please trust me, it's too hot. Please don't clutter your wardrobe by putting things that you just don't need because you feel that, oh, if it's going to rain, I might just wear it. Forget it. Most important, discard what has not been worn in over a year. What's the point? Discard what creases quickly if you hate ironing, because you're not going to get enough wear out of it if you hate ironing. If everything is in place, please keep whatever you like. Discard what makes you feel uncomfortable. I feel very uncomfortable in tops that have spaghettis with it, and I actually at some point in time purchased tons of them, and now that I feel that, okay, it's quite useless. So I've discarded them. Discard what does not make you feel happy, because certain colors, clothes or patterns, now here is a little bit of science. They are not going to be in harmony with what your eyes see. Harmony is the most important word in image consultancy, because your eyes scan the other person. And when they scan, they move in a certain direction. And if that direction is not in harmony with your personality, you will not feel confident in that piece of outfit. So please, just think about it, wear it, see how do your eyes move, ask your friends, take pictures, send it to your friends, people you trust the most, and then you can actually find out that probably that's the reason that, it does not look nice on me. So, take that big leap of faith and discard those. And again, discard whatever makes you feel less confident. And the next step is just organize category and then even color, and that is when you can actually feel that, I've done it, there is like a sense of calmness. And you can just put all your blue jeans together, all your white shirts together, all your pinks together. Just imagine how beautifully harmonious is it going to look, and how amazing you're going to feel when you take clothes out of that kind of a looking closet. It is beautiful. And before I could actually study about it, my sister did it. Fantastic job. And I actually loved it, So if you have a store, keep all your occasion wear, in that store, because you're not going to be wearing them every day. Why clutter your everyday wardrobe? Certain things are, they come across as no-brainers, but then we fail to actually use them and exercise these. Let's try doing it. So that when we go to the image consulting part, when you go to the styling part, we know ki kahan se kya uthana hai and how to, put that look together. Box all your accessories, box the smaller items, box your scarves, box your belts, everything. If there is a box, if you're wearing a white shirt, a blue jeans, something as basic as that, you can have 5 to 7 different looks because of the boxes that you have created. Because with a white shirt, blue jeans, you can take out a scarf and wear it. White shirt, blue jeans, you can take out a big broad belt. White shirt, blue jeans, you can just wear like nice chunky earrings or a nice necklace. Not and, please. Okay, so if you have boxed these items, you will know that these things, this organizing will take you a long, long way in this whole scheme of things. Now, as I promised, I will move to color analysis, which ideally should have been done with no makeup on, and which ideally should be done on you also if you have no makeup on only. But this is India. I cannot come on screen if I have no makeup on, because people are going to judge me, so I'm going to stay away from that. But color analysis is about finding your own season. So according to image consultants worldwide, they have come up with 4 seasons that almost every person will fit in. Okay, so maybe the variation of colors will matter, that okay, some kisi ko like a little more darker blue is going to suit, or a little lighter blue in that category is going to suit. But 4 seasons, winter, summer, autumn and spring. Basically, if somebody has a cool undertone, now what is an undertone and what is an overtone? Now that here is the difference. An overtone is what you can see on your face, okay? Maybe you are tanned, so you are maybe going to look a little bit darker or a little bit more brown. And versus if it's winter, so maybe you're going to look a little bit more pale. That's the overtone of the skin. But the undertone of the skin is the combination of red, blue and green in your skin. So the red color is what, you know, your hemoglobin is made up of. So the red, blue and green in your skin will give you the undertone. And that is how you can find out that what does my what does my skin project. I will show you a little bit about, you know, this color analysis by doing it on me. So since summer and winter are cool undertones, so the colors towards that gravitate towards blue will definitely look nice on you, and colors that have a little bit of warmth in them will look nice on people with autumn and spring undertones. Let me show you how. So I have, you know, two sets of fabrics, the first one being cool and this is warm. I will show you how these colors play on my skin. Let me start with orange and pink. So as you can see, orange gives a very warm, yellowy kind of a feeling, right? That, there is a little bit of warmth in it. And pink will give you a little bit of blue kind of a feeling. So guys, if you're able to judge this, half the battle is won. So, I mean, let me take this. I'm wearing white. Normally, I should be wearing a cape like this so that I do not get influenced by any other color on me. So, now that I've worn a white cape, there is orange. And there is pink. First of all, I just need five people telling me what do they think looks better on me, and then I'll give you the reasons quickly. Hi guys, if you can see me, just five people tell me whether orange looks nice on me or whether pink looks nice on me. That is your exercise, your fun exercise, and you will know why. You will just get the answers. Okay, I don't know if anybody can actually comment. I'm sorry. But anyways, moving on. Orange color versus pink. Do you see how pink makes my skin glow a little bit? See, there's a little bit of glow on my face. A very natural sort of a glow. And just follow this line, okay? There is no shading. My face looks thinner, longer, slimmer, and as soon as I put orange, you can see that there's a shading, you know, this part. There is some heaviness on my face. You can see the dark circles on my face. The darker areas have become more prominent. And if I had no makeup on, you could have actually felt that, oh my god, you know, you're looking sick, like ill. And versus pink, just see that, you know, these suddenly look a little less lighter. This behaves well, and you know, I naturally look better. So I hope that, you know, you're able to understand that how a color can actually influence the way you look. If I take two types of reds also, if I take a warm red versus a cool red, look what a warm red does. warm red and a cool red. So cool red will make my face glow, will again take care of the shading. It enhances my features. Whatever I am, I'm just looking a tad bit better. And as soon as I, you know, here, my darker spots look again very prominent. And this color wants you to look at the color first before you look at my face. I mean, this color is like, oh, look at me. If that's not the way it will happen on a lot of people. People who are warm, they will be able to pull off this color much better than this color. On them, this color is going to say, look at me. And then, you know, they'll be like, oh, you know, I mean, this is somehow not working. And as soon as I put this, it's going to work. So color analysis actually helps you. And then you can find out what your colors are like. This is a spring. So all these colors fall in the spring category. And if you want to get like, you know, personal color analysis done, post that color analysis, this is what you get. You get like, you know, swatches of colors that will look nice on you. So you can maybe take these out shopping, or you know, if you have to get suits or Indian wear made, you can probably choose these colors. And invariably, you're going to look nice in them. So please, you know, if at all you're interested in this color analysis, you're most welcome. Nevertheless, I will give you a 3-way test of how to do this color analysis on your own. You can do it. It works out for some people perfectly, but for some, they might not be able to gauge whether or not they fit in the right category. So the first thing that you have to do is do a vein test. Okay, what's the color of your vein? If it's blue, you are cool, your undertone is cool. If it's warm, if it's green, your undertone is warm. So a cool undertone and a warm, some people have, like, you know, they are unable to gauge ki, I think mere dono hai. So well, those people are the ones who must get this color analysis done. Please guys, before spending a bomb on clothes, on you know, the things that are in this season, but somehow they don't look nice on you, get yourself analyzed, because it just helps. For the longest time, you know, even when I went for my color analysis, I was like, oh, orange looks the best on me. And I had like 3-4 outfits in orange. I was not wanting to budge from the fact that the warm color is, you know, my skin. But as it turned out, I was more in the cool category. And I am supposed to be wearing, you know, more of blacks and whites and pinks and stuff like that, rather than the browns and oranges, which somehow make up most of my wardrobe, and it's time to discard a lot of them, which I already have, by the way. So the first two steps are your vein test, the orange and pink test. So the colors that I showed you, try them on. A lot of things, you know, you'll get to know when you check those two colors on yourself. And the third is your gold and silver test. So if silver looks nice on you, you are a cool person. If gold looks nice on you, you are a warm person. I will show you this, you know, silver and gold test. I'll just do it when I talk about accessories going forward. So you can just do these three, and then you might be able to find out which category do you fit in. Do you have like a warm undertone, or do you have a cool undertone? And then you can probably shop for, like, you know, the reds that I showed you. You can shop for a cooler red than a warmer red, and so on and so forth. Color analysis, definitely, like, you know, there is a lot more that goes on there, which I don't think I'll be able to finish up in, you know, the remaining 5 minutes. There's a lot that I really want to cover. There are a lot of things that I wanted to share with you. So if you want this color analysis, this is definitely a good way of getting it done. Now, I have a few issues for styling that I wanted to, you know, take care of, that people really face issues with. So the first one would be how to take attention away from a big bust, if at all you are someone who suffers from that kind of a problem. The first, let me talk about the do's. The first thing that you should do is wear darker colors on top. Okay, a no-brainer. Second, shift focal points. Now, focal point is something that you create on your own. If I put something very chunky here, I want the attention to be here. Doesn't make sense. If my neckline is like this, I am going to be, you know, dragging attention in this part. So shift the focal point. Shift it here. you know, let people notice what you have going on here. If you have like a nice cap or a piece of jewelry, or you know, say smaller pin tucks, or some other interesting neckline. So the focal point is going to shift from here to here, because I told you the eye travels, and if the eye is traveling, it's going to sit here first, and if it sits here, it's going to stay and then scan the rest of your body, whichever parts you have highlighted. So then again shift the focal point up. If you've done that, create only one focal point, please, guys. You know, don't just go on working on the rest of, I mean, just don't do everything and say that, okay, you know, now it's just going to look more like a khichdi. So if the focal point is up, good, you've achieved it. The third way is shift the focal point down. Wear a dark color, wear an interesting pattern down below, so that, you know, the attention goes there. So again, like, the eye is going to scan and stay where there is some exciting stuff happening. So maybe if you're wearing like a dark color, maybe your jeggings can have, or your pants can have some checks if you are slimmer in the bottom, or like, you know, pin dots, or pleats, or whatever you want to create, but just shift the focus down. So that way you can actually take the attention away from the bust area. Now, what you're not supposed to be doing, for people with a big bust, please do not wear waist belts like this, obviously, because you know your bust is going to look heavier. Do not wear horizontal lines with breast pockets. They don't work for you. Okay, so these are the two things that if you take care of, more or less, you can probably sort this issue out for yourself. Again, now the opposite. People with a smaller bust, what are the things that you can do and what are the things that you should not be doing? First, invest in a good push-up bra. It's again a no-brainer. I'm sure a lot of people would be doing it. Second, layer. The more layering you do, the fuller you're going to look. There is going to be more volume in the area that you really want to add, you know, something to. So, like, for example, if you're wearing a turtleneck, so turtleneck ke upar, maybe you're wearing like, you know, a shirt, and on top of that you're wearing you know, an overcoat. So there are three layers. So because of those three layers, there's going to be a little bit of volume that's going to be added to this area. So you can enjoy, you know, wearing those kind of things also. The next, you can wear lighter colors with horizontal trims. The things that are a big no for people with big breasts, you can actually be doing it. You can wear horizontal trims with breast pockets. So, you know, again, what you are actually accentuating or adding volume to that area. The third is wear short jackets, bolero style jackets, because they give an illusion that, you know, there is a little bit of volume in the area that you're wanting to highlight. What you're not supposed to be doing, do not wear tight tops with low cuts. So that is one thing that you should definitely stay away from. Guys, I have a lot more information. You guys can please stay if you want to. But I just want to quickly tell you that if you're interested in more such tips, I'm also rolling out a course for 30 days, 30 videos, 30 different concepts. And all this you can get for 3,000. So just in case you are interested, I will leave a Paytm number, or you can maybe note it down. The number is 9598393711. You can call on this number. You can find out what are the different modes of payment, you know, if at all you're interested in getting these tips or these handy tips, if they can help you in styling things in different ways. So I'm repeating the number for you. It's 9598393711. 3,000 rupees for 30 different concepts for 30 days. And all this you are going to get in your email. Okay. So anyways, moving forward, just in case anyone has any more questions, please feel free to DM me at any point in time. How to enhance a narrow bottom? How to enhance a narrow bottom? Of course, there are, like, you know, very there are people who might be interested in this also, unlike me. So choose a flared skirt with a little bit of stiff fabric, because what do we want to achieve? If you are like this, and actually, you know, this is your body shape, So if this is your body shape because your bottom is narrow, what does a skirt do? You know, a flared skirt. It does this. And what do you achieve? An hourglass figure. And that is what we want to achieve at the end of the day, right? We want to achieve that hourglass figure. And the same concept applies to tops with peplums. If you are this, and then you again wear a peplum, so this is what you're doing to your, you know, upper body. So that is another concept that's clear, right? Do not, and people with narrow bottoms, please do not wear pants or skirts closer to, like, you know, this part of your body, or baggy stuff, because it just makes, you know, it just gives an illusion that, oh, there is a lot missing in this portion. So people just, I mean, their attention is just drawn to that. So these are the scientific reasons, because if you want to achieve an hourglass figure, what are the things that you're going to do? You're going to give yourselves patterns and cuts which make you look like, yes, you do have it, correct? And now I'm just going to talk a little bit about accessories, and then we are going to call it a day. So what are accessories? Accessories include your shoes, bags, necklaces, earrings, rings, scarves, and nail paint and makeup. These are also parts of your accessories, you know, because of what lipstick shade that you apply, what color of nail paint do you apply, what's the eyeshadow that you are playing with, what's the color of your hair that you have actually played with. So these things also become a part of your accessories. And please guys, do not shy away from wearing accessories, because not wearing them does not make you look elegant. Please, that's like the last rule that one needs to follow. Create one focal point with whatever accessories that you're wearing and start building up on your accessories. I just want to tell you one thing. Please build up on your accessories by starting with neutrals. So neutrals would be blacks or grays or browns, whatever colors work for you. I mean, especially if you are in the cool undertones, so blacks would be your thing, and if you are in the warm undertones, then browns will be your thing. So a black pair of heels, a scarf with black which is prominently present, a black bag, and a black bag with maybe say silver or gold, depending on if you are a cool undertone, then you can definitely go for a black and silver. And if you're a warm undertone and if you just like gold, then make sure that the gold is very little on that black bag, okay, so that you don't really clash your accessories, the rest of them, with that black bag. I mean, I've made like so many mistakes. I'm so glad for having done this course, because now I know what are the things that I can keep and use, and what are the things that I have to discard, because this was lying with me since the last, I think, 8 years now, and now it has actually become, like, you know, one of the front runners of my the way that I accessorize, because as soon as I remove silver and put gold on myself, see, first, does it do any good to me? Do I look more elegant if I have just removed this? Or if I just remove this, it's not going to make me look elegant. It's just maybe going to make me look a little bit more incomplete. So instead of this, if I put a gold, does it add anything? It just doesn't do anything to me. It's flat. So the fact that silver works on me just goes to say that I am a cool undertone. You know, I should be wearing things. And if you're saying that, okay, this is chunky and this is light, this is layered enough. This has a lot of layers to actually compete with this. So I am cool, right? So a lot of people who are cool or warm, if you can gauge and if you can find out, and you know, if you can sort out your wardrobe, that is going to be like the best thing that you will do to yourself. Thank you so much, guys. Despite the fact that I still do have a lot more to share, maybe next time I'm going to use it, but without taking much of your time, I'm going to repeat myself. 9598393711 is the number. In case you want to enroll for 30 days, you'll get 30 videos of 30 different concepts, and all of those concepts are just going to have mind-blowing tips. I hope you enjoyed this session as much as I did in creating it for you. I wish I had more time. I would have definitely shared a lot more with you. But thank you so much. It was a pleasure. Thank you for hearing me. And it means a lot to me. Bye-bye.